Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. I'm so happy to be back and finish with my super intense work block from the past month. Although it is super fun to do so and get paid to do it, it is very hard to find something that will replace the amount of fun that I have making videos for you guys. So recently, I've been in talks with some of my photographer friends who want to make the transition from the hobby enthusiast phase to professional. And I'd be super hyped for any of my friends or any of you, the audience, who are going to start making steps towards becoming professional photographers or videographers. But I also understand that it's a very confusing, daunting, intimidating task to do something that you used to do for fun, maybe for months or maybe years, to something that you get paid for. Imposter syndrome, all of this like logistical stuff is very, very scary. And I certainly remember when I had to go through all of that back in 2018 when I was building my creative brand and there weren't that many useful resources out on YouTube yet, let alone the internet as a whole. So if you, the viewer, have been thinking about or struggling to make that transition from hobby enthusiast photographer, videographer to professional, I hope these 5 steps that I'm about to share with you guys will help you launch in the right direction. And of course, these 5 steps that I'm going to be talking about that I used for myself worked for me. It may not necessarily work for you. Take it as a grain of salt. Hopefully you can modify to your context, to your business, but you have the absolute freedom to do things however way you want. Now let's start off this discussion with step number one, defining the source. This is going to be probably the most important part throughout this entire like brand creating process, because if you want to be a wedding photographer or a shoe photographer, car photographer, you have to really ask yourself, do you actually really like what you're photographing? Because look, if you want to be some 5-star boutique lifestyle clothing photographer making well over 6 figures for the next 5 to 25 years, but you actually don't give a crap about clothing, you're going to be very, very sad and very, very burnt out. So you have to ask yourself this very important question. What is the source of all of your excitement, your passion? What is the origin of your emotion making photos? As a professional creative for the past few years, I've observed from my brand and also other people's brands, whether they are in the photo world or not, that the source of their inspiration and emotion are actually interchangeable in terms of the top priorities between these two major things, and that's personality and interests. Or the other way around. In the context of photography, most of the times you're gonna see professionals base their source of inspiration in life on their interests like automotive or weddings, so on and so forth. And that's what will define their niche. Now, just because they chose to specialize in one or two things doesn't mean they can't photograph something else. Like a wedding photographer can also photograph food if need be, but they just chose to devote most of their time and energy on that niche so that they could maximize their efficiency to bring in revenue income in that industry of their choice. That is their source. So that's one camp, one school of thought. There is also another camp, another group of people such as myself, where we base our source of inspiration on something a little bit more general, a little bit more abstract, like our love for people, our love for connecting, our love for bringing things together or documenting life. Basically, it's based on our personality. Now, basing your creative brand on your personality is going to be very inefficient compared to someone who chooses a niche, chooses a specialty like just wedding photography. But the reason that I picked it was because that worked the best for me. It seemed the most sustainable and most exciting for me. I'm very good at photographing certain things, other things not so much. But if I were to only pick one specialty and one niche to focus on for the next 5 to 25 years of my life, I'm going to be extremely bored. It's also reflected in my YouTube channel. My topics aren't just fit into one lane. It's based on my personality and what I like in a whole array of interests. And for the longtime subscribers and viewers and even the customers and clients that I've worked with, they very much know that the editing, the workflow, the type of communication is very much me. For the people who specialize in something, they have a more industry focused way of doing things and they love to do it because it works for them. So you get to decide, you, the viewers, you get to decide on how you want to do this. Of course, there's a third, fourth, fifth way of establishing your own brand, but these are two things that I've observed of, you know, establishing that source of inspiration. Is it going to be your personality first and interest second, or interest first and personality second? Because the people who specialize in what they specialize in doesn't mean that they don't have personality in their work, but it's just, you know, that interchangeability of that prioritization between those two major things. Now, that was a very long-winded explanation of step number one, but moving on to step number two, you got to start planning your choreography. According to an analysis done on Usain Bolt's gold medal performance in the 2012 Olympics, Bolt only took 41 steps in the entire race. Can you imagine 41 strides to run 100 meters in less than 10 seconds. That is absolutely insane. And even, and like, if it's only gonna be like 41 steps, that's almost like a dance choreography. You just gotta plan your steps and hope for the best that you become the world champion for the next 4 years. Isn't that kind of insane? And another example that I love to use in real life, I use this analogy all the time if you know me personally, boxers. Boxers know that they have a limited amount of punches in their arms in any given round, in any given match. Like, you can't just be like throwing haymakers like in the entire round and, you know, kind of hope that your body won't run out of energy. You will run out of energy so fast, your arms just get gassed. So each punch, each hook, each jab has to have some sort of intent. Now, with those analogies in mind, I want you to try your best to apply that type of mentality to building your creative brand. Each photo set, each project that you're gonna be using to build that portfolio, to build your brand, has to have a high level of intent. So for myself, back in 2019, I decided that my source is gonna be my personality. All the look, composition, all the projects are going to be very much me. And secondarily, it's gonna revolve around my interests, like shoes, cars, and clothing. I wanted to be a lifestyle photographer, so I decided, hey, I'm gonna make 3 knockout punches of a photo set of shoes, cars, and clothing, and I'm going to use that to build my portfolio and send it out to everybody to show that, hey, these are like 3 knockout punches and this is what it would be like to work with me. So for you, after deciding what your source of life, inspiration, and emotion is going to be, what are you now going to plan in terms of your choreography of the next 3, 5, maybe 10 shoots that's going to be a strong display of what that source is and what you want to be photographing and making? And thus, we move on to step number 3, the proof of concept. In my opinion, this is where it starts to get really fun because this is where the doing is. You've done all the theoretical, you've done all the conceptualizing, now you're taking that concept and you're making a physical proof of it. The whole point of this part is to show, hey, if you work with me, this is what the end product will potentially look like. It's going to have this look, it's going to have this kind of process, and you could even make a video of how you create this digital artwork or this video, make a video of making a video, or make a video about how you created these photos. A YouTube channel could be a great place to do that. For myself, because I want to be in the commercial lifestyle space, I needed you to believe that what I'm about to create will garner attention and sell products. And I did so with this fake ad Nike shoot. So I recruited my friend Mitchell, who is not a model, but damn, is he a handsome man. He is just a regular dude, a friend that I grew up with. Instead of photographing a hoodie and jeans clad consumer wearing some pretty sick kicks, I want to change it up a little bit, make it a little bit different. And my concept was formal meets sneakers. So it was gonna be a pea coat, scarf, umbrella to make it a little bit more fancy, and of course at the feet some nice kicks. Of course, we didn't have like Jordans or anything. My intent going into that was I didn't want the shoe to be too high end where it wouldn't really sell to like a general consumer. I want to bring it down a notch so that I can show that the shoe doesn't have to be flashy for it to sell or to make the photo look good. The shoot was an incredible success. Even though it was raining, it actually played into our favor with some reflections and even the use of the umbrella and the formal wear that he was, you know, donned in. And I made sure to model my colors and also my compositions after what Nike actually puts out on their website and in their digital marketing. After I was done editing, I slapped the PNG of the Nike logo on top of the photo. I started putting out on Instagram, putting out on all my socials, and it started garnering a lot of attention. People started looking at it. Nobody from Nike saw it, which is fine, whatever, it's totally cool, but it got people's attention. And now like the bar of my brand got raised up this high, and I started to erase a lot of things on my portfolio, erase a lot of things on anything that showed my professional work that didn't show as much intent as that fake Nike shoot did. So this is an example of how you can come up with a proof of concept that will elevate your brand, elevate the quality of your work, and make sure after you do that like high quality work, don't have any low quality work that'll pull down that prestige of the photo set, okay? Make sure that your portfolio is clean. Step number 4 is super duper important because this could save you a lot of time and energy if done correctly, and that is to make the photos work for you. A couple ways you can do this is to spread your photos on Instagram stories and to make highlights. I have a specific video about this. There's a little annotation right here, so go out and check that. But the whole point of this step is for you to not always have to send your photos in every single direction, but actually have it be moving around, mobilizing without you having to put effort behind it. Of course, after that Nike shoot, I put it out on my Instagram stories for the full 9x16 glory to be viewed in front of other people's eyes. I used it in different combinations, different compositions of sequencing, and I put it in my story highlights so that it could live longer than 24 hours because that's how long Instagram stories last. But one thing that I incorporated was to actually make wallpapers for people to use on their iPhone lock screens. I took different lifestyle photos that could be iPhone wallpapers, and I also used my old landscape photos that are still very eye-popping and very captivating. And I said like, hey, do you want this free wallpaper? And I put it on my Instagram story. It says like, hey, on the next slide, hold your finger down, take a screenshot, and put it as your wallpaper. Now, this is a very important tactic because the old school way of spreading your work around on other people's wall is to sell prints. And of course, it'll live on someone's wall, whether it's like in the room or in the living room, but how many people are going to see that? Not everybody goes to this one guy's house who has all your prints, right? The walls that we have that are super mobile are right here on this little rectangle in our pockets. Can you imagine if you made a really sick shot, someone downloaded that lock screen that you made for Instagram stories, they open up their phone or they see a notification and someone next to them is like, yo, that's a sick photo, where'd you get that? And then it spreads and spreads and spreads. This is one super duper effective way to having your photos work for you, to work on their own, to mobilize your brand. And there are other things that I'll be talking about in the future, but that should be a whole video in itself. Actually, I could go on for days about this tip and also like the first one, which I actually did. So of course, you still got to do the hard work of sending your photos out, marketing yourself, but try to come up with some ways for it to be mobilizing itself without you having to do it with your own hands, without your own input every single minute of the day. I'm sure you could come up with something very creative. The last tip that I'm gonna share with you guys for building a very successful creative brand is to be responsive and to be prepared. When someone sends you an email about an inquiry for a job, make sure you respond to that email, even if the inquiry is not something that you wanna do. Your brand will suffer immensely if you are not a responsive person, if you're not someone who pays attention to detail, because people will talk about how unresponsive you are, and that'll hurt you so much and ruin a lot of the progress that you made in the past four steps. Another thing to, you know, kind of be prepared for is to be prepared. If you get called up to the plate, if these shoots that you've been doing, the 3 to 10 shoots that you've been doing to build up your creative brand are so strong, someone hires you and you are just out of your mind, unprepared, you don't know how to do something, you don't know how to respond, or you don't know how to communicate, or when you're on set, you forgot your memory card, you forgot your light, you don't know how to run things, you have to be prepared for when the opportunity arises. And that's why you should keep practicing how these companies that you want to work for, this type of work that you want to be making, you have to practice and learn, how are they making that lighting this way? How did they come up with this location setting? How did they come up with that concept, and how did they make it? Learn and learn and learn and learn and learn. The internet is starting to eliminate a lot of excuses that we used to make for not knowing how to do something. I think today you actually have no excuse for not having a reason to learn a certain thing that you want to do or something that you're passionate about. You have no excuse. You can look it up, you can YouTube it. This video is trying to fill in that gap so that you don't have excuses for why you don't know how to build your creative brand. Of course, there are many steps, again, this is only 5 that I've taken myself, and it'll take some time to build that creative brand. But hey, if you already got it right from step number 1, defining that source, you are well on your way. Times are changing. You yourself will be changing. So you have the freedom to mess up. You have the freedom to learn, correct yourself, and move on. I want to encourage you that it's not going to be a easy road moving forward into your professional work sphere or whatever, but I encourage you that you can do it. If I can do it, you can do it. That's all I have for you guys in this video. It was a very long one. I think I've been recording for 45 minutes now, so I gotta cut this video down to like at least a third of that length. But it is so good to be talking to you guys about such an important topic. I hope you guys take these steps into mind, consider it, modify it as you will, and good luck on your creative ventures. Make sure you like this video, subscribe, comment down below about what you thought, and share this with your friends who might wanna start their own creative business too, because building a brand is a very confusing, intimidating, and just a weird time. Make sure you check check out my Patreon link down in the description below, because these types of videos that I'm putting out right now is an example of Patreon videos that I'll be making to help creatives move on to the next step of making their own business. So if you guys want to join that Patreon, I would be highly, highly grateful for it. But I'm already highly, highly grateful for all my subscribers and viewers who comment, like, and subscribe every single day. Well, you can't subscribe every single day. But thank you so much for watching this, and I will see you guys and girls in the next video. Peace.